Hello everyone, it's Roberta from Roberta's Artistic Adventures. I'm back to do a video. Nina Ribena is doing one where she is just doing paint all over a paper and then stamping and doing a lot of layering. And so I want to do a little bit of that today. I'm going to just go ahead and get into it. And not talk a lot. I'm just going to go ahead and play with the art. And she has a much bigger piece of paper that she's working on. I'm just working on a regular 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper. And the lighting is not that great on my video today. I'm not in my old apartment. I'm in my daughter's house and the lighting isn't that great, obviously not set up for doing videos. Trying to keep the paper in one place so it is in screen. This color is Poppy. It's actually one of my absolutely favorite colors. Nice vibrant orange. This is actually the kind of artwork that I really enjoy doing because it's something you can do without overthinking, and because you're doing so many layers, you're able to come up with very unique designs and patterns. And if it looks like you're not going to be happy with it, you can always add more layers, and the previous layers adds more texture and background that is pushed to the back but still is slightly visible, making it very pretty. I have most of this covered, not all of it, and now I want to do some stenciling, and I forgot to get some sponges. Some of these need to be shaken up and others not. Actually, I want to do the whole background with this. This kind of helps to push the colors to the background so that the new layers on the top are more visible. And this is a stencil that APG Jamie artist poet girl, Jamie Lynn, sent to me in some happy mail about a month ago. And I love this one. She told me what the name of it is, and I don't remember. But I really like it. When your sponge has a bit too much paint, it puts a bit too much through to the backside and makes the design not crisp and clear. But because there's going to be more layers over the top, that is not going to really be a problem. Try to position this so I can finish this layer through the bottom. And the edges, I'm not going to do as much as I did the center. Today I'm being a bad girl. Today I am putting off taking care of my livestock, my chickens, so that I can get a little bit of art in. I haven't been able to do much. Okay. That's that one stencil. Jamie also sent me this one. And I really like, I don't know if this is called damask or not, but I want to put this on here as well. And I'm just going to put it in the center. This I do want to try to get as dark and full of coverage as possible. This is one of my all-time favorite colors, the Wild Iris from Apple Barrel. It's the one I buy over at the Walmart. They're 50 cents for the regular bottle. The gloss costs more than a dollar, but these are only 50 cents. I also have this stencil by Jamie, and this one has the letters of the alphabet and numbers, and I've wanted one of these stencils for a while because I like the way that numbers and letters added on to this type of a project look. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and use the sponge I used with the Wild Iris with the black as well. And this doesn't have to be as dark, and nor is it going to be full coverage or consistent. stencils. I was going to use this one from Walmart. It's a Waverly stencil. I'm opting not to use that at this time. And this one I think I will use. I'm always setting my stencil in the ink. I want to use some of the excess ink that we have here and use some of the different items that I have. This is just a lid to like a biscuit can with a Lego and some shelving stuff cut to the shape. And so I'll use the yellow one. I can use it as a stamp. It adds extra of the paint so it gets a texture. It's a little bumpy. This is a cheap set of piping for frosting. And it leaves some really interesting little marks. They look kind of like flowers. They're very, very tiny. It's hard to see them. And it takes a couple practice tries before you get the actual texture and look that you're going for. I try not to press too hard at first. And then I add more pressure. And I have these, which come off the top of antiperspirant and deodorants, which give you different shapes, because we all have circle shapes in almost everything we have. This is from a cheap jar of coffee, so it's a rounded rectangle. This is off a can of BB pellets, so that's a nice new shape. A little Monopoly hotel makes a good square shape. Thank you. And I can wash these all out a little bit later. I'm not going to worry about them now. I'm going to pull out some more of the white. Add it to this yellow. Add some of this pink. And a drop of wild iris. No idea what I'm going to get with that. Just doing it for fun. I'm trying to get this off so I can use it. Off. Get the